मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑफलाइन क्लासेस फॉर 8th स्टैंडर्ड। वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर कॉल्ड कंजर्वेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स। इन पार्ट वन वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिफॉरेस्टेशन, वी डिस्कस्ड एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ डिफॉरेस्टेशन एंड कॉज ऑफ डिफॉरेस्टेशन वी आर डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल इन पार्ट वन। एंड टुडेस क्लास इन पार्ट टू वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द conservation of forest and wildlife. How to conserve this forest and wildlife? Is there any other method? So wildlife means, what is wildlife? The place where we see the plants and animals which live in wild area. So that is called wildlife. The plants and animals which are living in a wild area, that together what we called wildlife. Even the wildlife is also we need to conserve. So yesterday I have given one example, sometimes tigers and cheetah, they are entering in the cities. Why? Because when we are destroying their natural habitats, they are going to enter in the cities and they are going to harm to the peoples. So that we need to preserve them or we need to conserve them. So how can we conserve them? What other methods are there to conserve the wildlife? So there are different methods are there to conserve here. Even government has made number of steps has taken to conserve these wildlife. What they have step they have taken? They have taken the biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries and the national parks are used and constructed for conserving the wildlife. So here, the forest and wildlife can be conserved by setting up areas like biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries, and national parks. And even there are many other examples are there. Zoos are there, botanical gardens are there. But here, some important, if you go there are three important things, that is water, the place where we can conserve the wildlife and forest. That is what? The biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries, and the national parks. So what is biosphere reserves? A large areas of protected land for conserving of biodiversity and the traditional life of the tribal tribes living there. So it is means, what is biosphere reserves means water? It is a large area where we can able to protect the wildlife. Why? That is what? Biodiversity. Biodiversity means what? It is the place where we can see all the different kind of plants and animals. That is the place called biodiversity. It has been diversified throughout entire area. And even the traditional life of the tribals, and even some people who are living in forest and wild area, those also protected in that particular area. That area what we call the biosphere reserves. And even national parks. The national parks are the areas reserved for wildlife where they can freely use the habitats and natural resources. Here another one more way of protecting the wildlife is what? A national park. So national park is totally a reserve for wildlife. So nobody is going to enter in that, because it is a national park is what a kind of habitat for the wildlife. So they can live freely, so without any disturbance. So they can live freely without any kind of disturbance from anyone else, and even they can utilize the natural resources which is available in that particular area or that national park. So that is also one more way that we can able to protect or conserve the wildlife. The next one is what? Wildlife sanctuaries. So wildlife sanctuaries are the areas where animals are protected from any disturbance to them or their habitat. So here it is also another method of protecting the animals. This is the sanctuaries is totally meant for the animals, where the animals can be protected or conserved without any disturbance for their natural habitat, and they can able to utilize the sources which are available around them. So these are the methods can be used for protecting or conserving water, wildlife and forest. The next, if you go to that, the biosphere reserves. Again, if you go to in detail, if you go to biosphere reserve, what it states, again I already told you that the biosphere reserve is a large area where it has been protected as a land for the conservation of biodiversity and the traditional life of the tribals are living there. And next comes to the biodiversity, is the variety of plants and animals and microorganisms found in this. So what is biodiversity? It indicates what biodiversity is, means it is the place where we can see different kind of organisms, including microorganisms. The place where we can see plants, the place where we can see the animals, and even we can see the microorganisms. That is called what the biodiversity. So some examples here, if you see the biosphere reserve, that is what a Pachamani biosphere reserve consisting of national park called the Satpura and the two wildlife sanctuaries called Gori and Pachamari. So this is an area where we can see all the different kind of animals and plants and even microorganisms. Next comes to the flora and fauna. What is flora and fauna? The flora means the plants found in a particular area is called flora. The fauna means what the animals found in a particular area is called a fauna. Example, the flora of Pachamari consisting of salt, teak, wild, mango, jamun, a silver ferns. So here we see that, so this is a place called what a flora, and this is called what a fauna. So here we in the fauna area we can see the different Pachamari. So there we can see different kind of flora. What is flora? The place where we can see the different kind of plants or trees. The examples of here, these we can see salt, teak, wild mango, jamun, silver ferns, and extra we can see in the Pachamari flora. In the same way, we can see Pachamari fauna, we can see different kind of animals like wild dog. We can see wild dog and cheetah and wolf, leopard, blue bull, and barking deer we can see in the fauna of Pachamari. This is about the flora and the fauna. Then if we go to the next part about the endemic species. So what do you mean by endemic species? So endemic species are those species of plants and animals found only in a particular area and not found in anywhere else. Means the animals which can be seen only in particular area. We can't able to see those animals in other areas. For example, polar bear. The polar bear is animal we can see only in the Himalayan places. So it can only live in that particular places. We can't see it. So it won't be seen in any other places. Like in the same way, penguins we can see in the near the seashore. So there, but apart from that, we can't see anywhere else. So such animals, what we call what the endemic animals. So endemic means what? The animals can be live in one particular area. For example, the blue whale. The blue whale we can see in the seas and oceans. So we can't able to see in the river or somewhere in the pond or the lake because it is an endemic animal which lives in the only one particular area. The example, this and even the, not only animals, even in the plant also comes here. The plant species. Some plants which grow in the only particular area. So usually you see that the apples usually we see growing in the Kashmiri places because in the place where it can grow. But why? Because it is the plants or animals they are growing or they live in a particular area, it is quite suitable for them to live in that particular area. Hence they are called as what endemic species or endemic plants or maybe endemic animals. So examples here, if you see the endemic species of animals and plants, that is example sap and the wild mango are the endemic flora of Pachamari, and bison, Indian giant squirrel and the flying squirrel are the endemic fauna of this area. So there are two different endemic flora and fauna we can see in the Pachamari biosphere. There the fauna, flora, if you go there, sal and wild mango, the fauna, flora of endemic species of Pachamari, and the bison, Indian giant squirrel and the flying squirrel are the endemic fauna we can see in the Pachamari. You just see that wild mango how it is, and this is what sal, these are the animals, the bison and the squirrels and flying squirrels we can see in that particular places. Next comes to the wildlife sanctuaries. So wildlife sanctuary means what? Wildlife sanctuaries are the areas where animals are protected from any disturbance to them or their habitat. The killing or the capturing of animals in wildlife sanctuary is strictly prohibited. Very important. Right? So this is the wildlife sanctuary is totally meant for the animals. The animals, the wild animals are protected in these places called a wildlife sanctuaries. In that particular place, the animals are protected in that particular places without any disturbance of their natural habitat. And even they are providing all the things which is required for their living, survival. So that is called one of wildlife sanctuaries. And even those which has been protected in that particular area called sanctuaries, where if any persons, if they try to kill them or if they try to hunt them, they are completely prohibited, and even it is they are considered as a kind of offense, and they need to be punished under the law before the law. These are what a wildlife sanctuary. Just see that this is a wildlife, and we can see the number of elephants over there, and even the different kind of birds and animals we can see there, and even monkeys we can see. This is what the sanctuary is, where wildlife are or animals are protected. Okay. So next is what the national park. National parks are the area reserved for wildlife where they can freely use their habitats and natural resources. Here, so national parks means this is also one more way of protecting or conserving of the wildlife. So they, the place where we can protect the wildlife, both plant and animals, and they can freely they can utilize their habitats, and even they can utilize the natural sources which is available around them. Are available around the national park, they can use, and there is no disturbance for them, and they can be able to freely they can live in their areas. So example, some example here, natural park, but Satpura National Park is one of the example. The first, it is the first reserve forest in India. So this is about some important method of conserving of wildlife and the forest. Okay, in the next class we will discuss in detail about more about the chapter. Thank you.